الشعر حينما القرآن معجزات وحكمة وبيان ينصت الكون والملائك حفت مجلسا قد أظله الرحمن يسكت الشعر حينما القرآن معجزات وحكمة وبيان ينصت الكون والملائك حفت مجلسا قد أظله الرحمن حلقة تحت سلبها وتسقي مسجدا تنتشي به الجدران.
الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهد الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد، ever since the dawn of life on this planet, man has always searched to understand nature and his own place in this miracle of creation, and the reason for life and its purpose itself, and for which reason he was brought to this earth. In simpler terms, وَمَا قَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ, to worship Allah. But in man's quest for the truth, spanning many civilizations and many diverse cultures and centuries, religion has shaped a large part of the human being, and to extend the course of history itself. While some religions have been based on books that their adherents believe to be, their adherents or their followers believe to be divinely inspired, others have relied on the human experience alone. Al-Quran, as Muslims, we believe that Al-Quran is divinely inspired. It is the main source of our faith, along with the Sunnah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We as Muslims believe it is our guide in this world, the reason, the whole reason it was brought about. But more to the matter, is a source of guidance for all of humanity. So over the course of 1,400 years, does the Quran pass this test? The test of humankind and the test of age. Prepare to find out.
ألف لام را كتاب أحكمت آياته ثم فصلت من لدن حكيم خبير.
ألف لام را. This is a book, the verses wherefore are perfect, and then explained in detail from one, meaning Allah, who is wise and well accurate with all things, which meaning that the Quran has no mistakes, that it is explained in detail.
It is all in the Quran. Oceanography, astronomy, biology, physics, chemistry, botany, embryology, neurology, and geology. All of these, in other words, all of these fields of science that the human is studying today in their universities and research facilities were mentioned in the Quran 1,400 years before the first ever facility of science or the facility of thought. So we as human beings, we see these, all of these fields of science that need complex tools to be explained in the Quran 1,400 years before the first microscope or the first machine that can conduct cells or the first superconductor 1,400 years before that. Isn't that amazing?
أَوَلَمْ يَرَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا أَنَّ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ كَانَتَا رَتْقًا فَفَتَقْنَاهُمَا وَجَعَلْنَا مِنَ الْمَاءِ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ حَيًّا أفلا يؤمنون.
Have not those who disbelieved known that the heavens and the earth were joined together, as one unit of creation before we clove them asunder. In other words, in simpler terms, this means that the samawat above and the earth at one point were together until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose the time for them to separate. Asunder, they went apart. The science of modern cosmology clearly indicates that at one point of time, the whole universe was nothing but a cloud of smoke, an opaque, highly dense and hot gaseous composition. This is one of the undisputed standards of science, or the principles or standards of modern cosmology. Scientists now observe that a new star is forming from the remains of that smoke. So basically, it's scientifically proven that what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran 1,400 years ago about the samawat and the earth being one unit of gaseous, hot clouds, at one point, that was what the entire universe was. And now, modern science has studied that new stars are born from this gaseous complexion. Because of the earth and the heavens have been formed from the same smoke, we conclude that the earth and the heavenly bodies were once connected, a one connected entity. Then out of this humongous smoke, they formed and they separated from each other, as the Quran indicates.
الله الذي خلق سبع سماوات ومن الأرض مثلهن يتنزل الأمر بينهن لتعلموا أن الله على كل شيء قدير وأن الله قد أحاط بكل شيء علما.
Allah, He who created seven firmaments and on the earth a similar number, though the mightiest of them all descends His command, that ye may know that Allah has power over all things and that Allah comprehends all things in His knowledge. Allah is the one who made the seven layers before scientists had discovered it. Allah is the one who made fire come down from the sky and make iron, set the layers of earth, to throw sulfur, water, ash then sulfur, upper mantle, inner mantle, outer core, inner core. Those are the seven layers which Allah has created.
لقد أرسلنا رسلنا بالبينات وأنزلنا معهم الكتاب والميزان ليقوم الناس بالقسط وأنزلنا الحديد فيه بأس شديد ومنافع للناس وليعلم الله من ينصره ورسله بالغيب إن الله قوي عزيز.
We set down after time our messengers with clear signs and set down with them the book and the balance of right and wrong, that men may stand forth in justice, and we set down iron, in which is material for mighty war, as well as many benefits for mankind, that Allah may test who it is that will help, unseen him and his messengers, for Allah is full of strength, accelerated in might, and able to enforce his will. The new scientific discovery had also revealed that the metal iron was not created or formed from earth or earth material at all. Iron was sent down by burning stars traveling through space that had collided with earth. When those stars collided with earth and their metals cooled down and changed from liquids burned metal too hard to add solid metals, they formed the metal of what we call today iron, which means that 1400 years ago, Allah told us that to make iron that flying that shooting stars had to come hit Earth, and now the new scientific discoveries just found that out, but it was in the Quran.
The seven layers of the atmosphere: the troposphere, the stratosphere, the mesosphere, the thermosphere, the exosphere, the ionosphere, and the magnetosphere. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reveals this in the Quran 1,400 years ago, that the layers of the samawat, each of these being a certain sphere, the troposphere being the lowest one, somewhat the first samawat in general terms, and then each of the other six spheres coming after it, stratosphere, the mesosphere, and so on. So look how amazing this is, that modern science, it took them at least 600 years to figure this out. And the word, a fun fact, the word scientist isn't a word of the ages. It's a recently new word, only discovered in the 18th century. So it took science that long to figure this out, and yet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's messenger, an illiterate shepherd, figured this out, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him this ilm 1,400 years ago. The human embryonic development. In the Holy Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about the stages of man's embryonic development inside his mother's womb, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
وَلَقَدْ خَلَقَنَا الْإِنسَانَ مِنْ سُلَالَةٍ مِنْ طِينٍ ثُمَّ جَعَلْنَاهُ نُطْفَةً فِي قَرَارٍ مَكِينٍ ثم خلقنا النطفة علقة فخلقنا العلقة مضغة فخلقنا المضغة عظاما فكسونا العظام لحما ثم أنشأناه خلقا آخر فتبارك الله أحسن الخالقين.
We created man from an extract of clay. Then we made him as a drop in a place of settlement, firmly fixed. Then we made the drop into alaqah, leech, suspended thing, and a blood clot. And then we made the alaqah into mudqah, a chewed-like substance. Literally, the word alaqah has three meanings in the Arabic language: leech, suspended thing, and blood clot. As you see above, there is a leech and a human embryo. And don't be confused, the human embryo is on top. But you can see small parts of the yet developing human. You can see the forebrain on the top right there, and the heart right where its mouth would be, and then the amnion on its belly. So look at this miraculous thing, that this small thing has a brain, a heart, and an amnion while it's yet developing inside the mother's womb. And then if you look below that, you see an actual picture of the embryo during the alaqah stage in the womb of the mother. Alaqah being the chewed lump stage. When comparing the appearance of an embryo at the mudqah stage with a piece of gum that has been chewed, we find the similarity of the two. As you can see in figure A, this is an embryo right here. About this big, this piece of a chewed gum that you just took out of your mouth. And then you see piece B. So you see how significant the human being is when it's coming out of its mother's womb. That's the mercy of Allah showing you that you are so unimportant in this vast universe. You are not even a grain of sand on the beach with millions and trillions of grains of sand. You are insignificant. And yet you are so important. You are an individual who will be asked by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the day of judgment for everything that you did. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will call you to account. And look how insignificant you are inside your mother's womb.
In conclusion, Allah has said in Surah Al-Imran, "Behold, in the creation of the heavens and the earth, and the alternation of night and day, there are indeed signs for men of understanding." The scientific evidence of the Quran clearly proves its divine origin. No human could have produced such a book 1400 years ago that would contain profound scientific facts to be discovered by man centuries later. However, the Quran is not a book of science, but a book of signs. These signs invite man to realize the purpose of his existence on earth and to live in harmony with nature. The Quran is truly a message from Allah, the creator and sustainer of the universe. It contains the same message of the oneness of God that was preached by all prophets from Adam to Moses to Jesus to Muhammad. Several detailed books have been written on the subject of Quran and modern science. These books will help mankind to come closer to the word of the Almighty. But after all this has been shown to the disbelievers, they will still argue against it. Some people just want one sign, some 10 signs, some 100 signs. Some will just refuse the Quran as a whole. As mentioned in the Quran, Surah Al-Baqarah, deaf, dumb, and blind, they will not return to the path. The Quran contains a complete code of life for the individuals of society. Alhamdulillah. The way of the Quran is the way of life, and it is far superior. And who can give better guidance than the Creator himself? Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Jazakumullah khair.
أمن من لظى النيران ووعد جنة الريحان كتاب الله يا إخوان نور العلم والإيمان أمن من لظى النيران ووعد جنة الريحان
به التمكين والتأييد وفضل الله بالتوحيد على نور الهدى أنزل به المختار قد أرسل
كتاب الله يا إخوان نور العلم والإيمان أمن من لظى النيران ووعد جنة الريحان كتاب الله يا إخوان نور العلم والإيمان أمن من لظى النيران ووعد جنة الريحان
شفاء الهم والأسقام ويمحو الذنب والأسقام
موئلا أولا تبارك رحمن الرحيم وموئلا وثنيت صلى الله ربي على الرضا محمد المهدى إلى الناس مرسلا وعترته ثم الصحابة ثم من تلاهم على الإحسان بالخير وبلا وثلثت أن الحمد لله دائما وما ليس مبدوءا به أجذب العلا وبعد فحبل الله فينا كتابه فجاهد به حبل العدا متحبلا وأخلق به إذ ليس يخلق جدة جديدا مواليه على الجد مقبلا وقارئه المرضي قر مثاله كالترجح عليه مريحا وموكلا هو المرتضى أمن إذا كان أمة ويممه ظل الرزانة قنقلا هو الحر إن كان الحري حواريا له بتحريه إلى أن تنبلا وإن كتاب الله أوثق شافع وأغنى غناء واهبا متفضلا وخير جليس لا يمل حديثه وترداده يزداد فيه تجملا وحيث الفتى يرتع في ظلماته من القبر يلقاه سنا متهللا هنالك يهنيه مقيلا وروضة ومن أجله في ذروة العز يجتلى يناشد في إرضائه لحبيبه وأجدر به سؤلا إليه موصلا فيا أيها القاري به متمسكا مجلا له في كل حال مبجلا هنيئا مليئا والداك عليهما ملابس أنوار من التاج والحلا فما ظنكم بالنجل عند جزائه أولئك أهل الله والصفوة الملا أولو البر والإحسان والصبر والتقى حلاهم بها جاء القرآن مفصلا عليك بها ما عشت فيها منافسا وبيع نفسك الدنيا بأنفاسها العلا جزى الله بالخيرات عنا أئمة لنا نقلوا القرآن عذبا وسلسلا فمنهم بدور سبعة قد توسطت سماء العلا والعدل زهرا وكملا لها شهب عنها استنارت فنورت سواد الدجى حتى تفرق وانجلى وسوف تراهم واحدا بعد واحد مع اثنين من أصحابه متمثلا تخيرهم نقادهم كل بارعين وليس على قرآنه متأكلا فأما الكريم السر في الطيب نافع فذاك الذي اختار المدينة منزلا وقالوا نعيسى ثم عثمان ورشهم بصحبته المجد الرفيع تأثلا ومكة عبد الله فيها مقامه هو ابن كثير كاثر القوم معتلا روى أحمد البزي له ومحمد على سند وهو الملقب قنبلا وأما الإمام المازني صريحهم أبو عمرو البصري فوالده العلا أفاض على يحيى اليزيدي سيبه فأصبح بالعذب الفرات معللا أبو عمر الدري وصالحهم أبو شعيب هو السوسي عنه تقبلا وأما دمشق الشام دار بن عامرين فتلك بعبد الله طابت محللا هشام وعبد الله وهو انتسابه لذكوان بالإسناد عنه تنقلا وبالكوفة الغراء منهم ثلاثة أذاعوا فقد ضاعت شذا وقرنفلا فأما أبو بكر وعاصم اسمه فشعبة راويه المبرز أفضلا وذاك ابن عياش أبو بكر الرضا وحفص وبالإتقان كان مفضلا وحمزة ما أزكاه من متورع إماما صبورا للقرآن مرتلا روى خلف عنه وخلاد الذي رواه سليم متقنا ومحصلا وأما علي فالكسائي نعته لما كان في الإحرام فيه تسربلا روى ليثهم عنه أبو الحارث الرضا وحفص هو الدوري وفي الذكر قد خلا أبو عمرهم واليحصبي بن عامرين صريح وباقيهم أحاط به الولاء لهم طرق يهدى بها كل طارق ولا طارق يخشى بها متمحلا وهن اللواتي للمواتي نصبتها مناصب فانصب في نصابك مفضلا وها أنا ذا أسعى لعل حروفهم يطوع بها نظم القوافي مسهلا جعلت أبا جاد على كل قارئ دليلا على المنظوم أول أولا ومن بعد ذكر الحرف أسمي رجاله متى تنقضي آتيك بالواو فيصلا سوى أحرف لا ريبة في اتصالها وباللفظ أستغني عن القيد إن جلا ورب مكان كرر الحرف قبلها لما عارض والأمر ليس